you guys know that in Spanish, dark magician is translated to magro negro? And we already know what the B for Red Eyes B Dragon stands for. B's are bo- No, I'm just playing. Anyway, it stands for black. And that actually gave me the revelation that both of these decks or strategies, we have something in common. All of us being black. I think the only difference between us, me, and these two decks is that if I get pulled over by the cops, I don't think I'd be able to live to tell the tale. Whereas these two decks, I don't know. A magician just never reveals his secrets. I'm the Cali Effect, and if you guys want to see more videos like this, then go and destroy that subscribe button. But more importantly, go ahead and hit that notification bell because, well, we just too strong. I want to give a special time to give a shout out to every single one of my Patreons. Without you guys, videos like this would just not be possible. I really do appreciate you. It's so fun to play decks like this and give you guys awesome deck profiles. And welcome to our newest Patreon 4 times in a row. I hope I can say his name right. Tong Zion. I really, if I butcher your name, I apologize so much. I was actually trying to send you a message to try to get, you know, enunciation of your name. But for some reason, Patreon's just not working for me right now. And if we can get 5 times in a row, you guys would be awesome. But pretty happy with what we're doing on right now. Keep the streak alive. Without further ado, I present to you, hey, both a combination of the Red Eyes Black Dragon deck profile and a Dark Magician deck profile. You guys are going to get 2 profiles in 1. Too strong. Okay, so before we get into this, I just want to look at the stats of this or take you guys to the stats of both decks. They're pretty much similarly the same, which is why the stats are kind of like a mixture of both as opposed to 1 and 1. The best thing about this deck is that it has the ability to spam out rank 7s like crazy, giving you instant access to Tomahawk. But I want to say that both of these decks are really fun to play and should be that. They're just fun decks, guys. I would not take this at anything higher than the local level event. Don't get too crazy. I mean, you guys probably could. And if you could, send me your build. I'll be sure to mention you in a profile sometime down the line. So let's get on to the Dark Magician deck profile first. And I'm going to be going over this a little bit fast because everything is pretty easy to go over. 3 copies of Dark Magician. This is the main card of the deck. This is the monster you want to your hand or field as fast as possible, and you'll be able to abuse the other cards that circle around it. In order to get into that, we play 3 copies of Apprentice Illusion Magician. What she does is that you can discard 1 card from your hand to summon her to your side of the field, but even more importantly, she allows you to add Dark Magician from your deck to your hand. Now, if another dark monster attacks or is attacked, you can get rid of another dark monster to give that monster 2,000 attack. It's really good, and I hope I didn't butcher that effect. I'm sorry. You can send this card to the graveyard to get that attack. Next is 2 copies of Spellbook Magician of Prophecy. When this card is normal summon or flip summon, it allows you to add spellbook cards. That's really good for getting deeper into your engine, seeing that the spellbook engine is a draw engine. Next is 2 copies of Magician of Dark Illusion. I necessarily didn't love this card when I was playing it, but it's still a really, really good card, especially since we play more trap cards to summon it to our side of the field. Basically, what it does is if you activate a spell or trap card on your opponent's turn, you can summon this monster to your side of the field, and his name becomes Dark Magician. So it's actually really good at disrupting your opponent if you have the Magician Circle face up. Next is 3 copies of Magician Rod, the best low-level monster in the deck, because when he's summoned, you can add 1 spell or trap card that specifically lists Dark Magician from your deck to your hand. Also, more importantly, he can actually recur himself to your hand if you activate cards on your opponent's turn. That's it for the Dark Magician engine, and of course the little spellbook engine we have to draw into our cards. We do play 4 hand traps, and you guys can play whatever hand traps you want. I understand that this is obviously going to be more of a budget deck anyways. I run 2 copies of Drolling Lockbird and 2 copies of Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring. Now, you guys could run Ghost Ogres and Effect Veilers. I think those are the cheapest hand traps. Or you can decide to run no hand traps at all, and instead you can just run other cards like a 3rd Spellbook Magician of Illusion, a 3rd Magician of Dark Illusion. It doesn't matter. This is a very fun deck. And then lastly, I actually decided to tech this in as 1 copy of Sangyan. There is a huge combo with Sangyan to be able to make Nightmare Griffin, Nightmare Goblin, and then also be able to search a hand trap at the end of the combo sequence, and it involves Summon Sorceress. So if you guys are in TCG Europe, then you guys obviously don't even bother playing Sangyan. But even more importantly, Sangyan does, at the very worst, search Spellbook Magician of Prophecy. So that is it for that. For the spells, 3 copies of Magician, or Dark Magical Circle, my apologies. This card is really important to the deck. It's probably one of the most important cards to the deck because when it's activated, you get to dig through your deck, add a Dark Magician or a card that specifically missed Dark Magician from your deck to your hand. But even more importantly, every turn, once per turn, when a Dark Magician monster is normal or special summon, you get to banish a card on your opponent's side of the field. It's our Disruptor card, and it allows us to get deeper into our combos. Two copies of Dark Magic Inheritance. This card is another card to allow us to search our Dark Magician cards from our deck to our hand. One copy of Dark Magic Attack. This card is drugs. The fact that it's a Harpy's Feather Duster is just amazing. And one copy of Illusion Magic. By tributing a Spellcaster monster, you can add two copies of Dark Magician from your hand, deck, or graveyard to your hand. It's pretty good. Next, we're actually going to follow up with some pretty big anti-meta-like cards. Two copies of Secret Village of Spellcasters. My apologies. And setting Secret Village of Spellcasters up with Dark Magical Circle. Dark Magical Circle is basically going to prevent them from summoning Nightmare Phoenix. And Secret Village of Spellcasters is going to prevent them from playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And mainly because if you control a Spellcaster and your opponent does not, your opponent can activate spell cards. Now, there aren't a lot of great spellcasters in today's meta that I can think of on the top of my head. Trickstar is a fairy deck. Goki is a warrior deck. You're probably going to steal a couple games just through Secret Village of the Spellcasters with Dark Magical Circle. Next is two copies of Spellbook of Knowledge. This is to get you into your draw engine, as well as two copies of Spellbook of Secrets. It is Victoria's secret to this deck. I mean, you secretly want to get into your cards, but your opponent won't know. I find that this is probably the best variant. No Aya Tamias, because unfortunately, Aya Tamias is not searchable. It doesn't specifically state Dark Magician. It lists a Dark Magician monster. Other than that, we would probably try to figure out how to play Aya Tamias. I actually did have another build that used Sky Striker cards, but I was like, I'm pretty sure you guys are played on Sky Striker cards. And granted, it did have much of a higher ceiling, but let's be honest, even with the Sky Striker cards, this deck is not tier one, so it's almost no point in playing it. That's it for the spells. For the traps, three copies of Eternal Soul. This card is nutty good. It's probably the best trap card in the deck. Being able to special summon Dark Magician from your graveyard or hand to your side of the field once per turn really lets you pop off with your Dark Magical Circle, being able to banish a card on each player's turn. And it also allows you to add one Dark Magic Attack from your deck to your hand. So basically, it allows you to search Harpy's Feather Duster. Two copies of Magician's Navigation. Now, this deck works a little bit different than the other decks. You want Dark Magician in your hand because you play it really well with this other card that I'm going to show you. I didn't show you right in the build, but it ties to both decks. It allows you to special summon Dark Magician to your side of the field, and then another Dark Spellcaster monster to your side of the field as well, tutoring out plays, but it also has a great graveyard effect if you control a Dark Magician card, allowing you to negate a spell or trap card your opponent activates. Lastly is two copies of Metaverse, and Metaverse is better than Terraforming in this deck for this specific reason. It's actually the reason why I bumped up to play the deck. So if you have Magician of Dark Illusion and Metaverse, that is literally your Secret Village lock. You activate Metaverse, and you can activate your Secret Village, and you can special summon Dark Magician of Dark Illusion to your side of the field on your opponent's turn. So that's why I really decided to opt with Metaverse over Terraforming. That, and you know, it's just a really, really underrated card. You can just activate it immediately. It's an awesome card. So that's it for 38 cards. The last card I want to talk about ties into both decks, and it does it so well. Three copies of Cosmo Brain is played in both decks. What this card does is it can only be special summoned by sending one normal monster from your hand or field to the graveyard. I'm sorry, no, a non-effect monster. And after that, you can send one effect monster from your deck to your graveyard to special summon a normal monster from your deck to your side of the field. Now, it is a 7, so it tutors both your Dark Magician to your side of the field, and it tutors your Red Eyes. It has a little bit more use in the Red Eyes, or I'm sorry, in the Dark Magician build, just solely because it's a Spellcaster, and your other Dark Magician exceeds, contain Spellcasters. So you run three of these in both decks. I'll show you in the Red Eyes deck as well, just to show you the combos off with it. But for right now, talking about the Dark Magician, it allows you to get into some pretty awesome plays. For the links, we do get a little bit on the expensive side. Borlo Dragon, that's almost mandatory. Fortunately for us, it is going down. Nightmare Griffin is actually a really good card. It sets you your Metaverse back to your side of the field, which you can activate on your opponent's turn. It sets you your spell and trap cards that you need, such as if you already used Eternal Soul or whatnot. Saryuja is a great draw 4 card. Summoned Sorceress is a card that you guys could take out if you can't afford it, or if you're in TCG Europe. But it basically allows you to tutor other monsters, even Dark Magician, to your side of the field if it points to a Dark Magician card. Nightmare Unicorn, standard Nightmare card. Clefort Genius is for the Tomahawk play. So is Proxy Dragon. Nightmare Cerberus to destroy monsters. Goblin for the additional summon. You'll hardly use that, but it also points to the main monster zone. So you can get Nightmare Griffin into a main monster zone that your opponent doesn't have access to. And since it points left and right as opposed to the Nightmare monsters pointing up, you're in a pretty good position. Nightmare Phoenix, Two Link Spiders. That's also for... This is actually really good because it gets rid of normal monsters and allows you to keep using your effects. A lot of times you have Dark Magician in your main monster zone and you kind of want it to the graveyard so you can summon it again. So Link Spider it away and then summon it back to your side of the field. And then also have an Xyz play that points to your main monster zone as opposed to your extra monster zone. Galaxy Tomahawk for the play, of course. If you guys want to see this play, I'll link you to the video. I actually have an in-depth video about it. Ebon Nahai Magician. This card's awesome. Being able to just activate cards from your hand is just amazing. Imagine being able to activate whatever you want to your side of the field on your opponent's turn. And then Ebon Illusion Magician, you special summon another Dark Magician to your side of the field. And it's also just a flat-out great card. That is it for the extra deck for this deck. Now I can start talking to you guys about the Red Eyes deck. If you guys can't afford, hypothetically, the Tomahawk combo, which includes like the Borreload or whatever, play double highs, you know, all that other stuff. You can play other cards. It's a fun deck, guys. The only thing I want you to do is to have fun with this deck. And that's basically what it's all about. Next is the Red Eyes deck. And the Red Eyes deck is a little bit different. It's also another casual deck in its own sense. I think that both of these decks, again, are really awesome to play. And Cybernetic Horizons did give it that little bit of a boost. So starting off with the monsters, three copies of Red Eyes Black Dragon. I don't know its attack. Is it Flash Flare Blast? I think that's like Red Eyes Flare Metal. But this guy is, he is the guy of the deck. You need him just as much as important as you need Dark Magician. You're going to follow up with two copies of Red Eyes Black Feral Dragon. Card's a normal monster on the field and graveyard. It also is an effect monster. This card can actually hit for a ton of damage if you perform damage with this card. And inflicts an additional amount of damage, so it's pretty good. One copy of Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon. This card allows you to tutor Red Eyes monsters or dragon monsters to your side of the field. One copy of Blackstone, a legend. In my humble opinion, you only need one copy of this card. And you don't really need it often, so it's a pretty decent card. Three copies of Black Metal Dragon. This card is nutty. It becomes an equipped spell card from your hand or field. And then when it sends to the graveyard, you can actually add a Red Eyes card from your deck to your hand. So it's an awesome card. Three copies of Gearfreak, the Red Eyes Iron Knight. What this card does is that if a card is equipped to it, you can destroy the equipped card in an opponent's spell card. And that's during either player's turn. So, like, it's really good. Another effect is that you can send in a card equipped to it to spell summon a level 7 or lower Red Eyes monster from your graveyard to your side of the field. So, that's also a really good combination of bringing monsters to your side of the field. It's just a pretty good card. And then lastly is two copies of Paladin of Dark Dragon. This card is also awesome because it allows you to tutor Red Eyes monsters from your deck to your side of the field. Cough, cough, Red Eyes, Darkness, Metal Dragon, which allows you to go into more of your Link plays, Xyz plays, whatever you want to. For the hand traps, of course, we run the Ash Blossom, Joy Spring, and Drolan Lockbird. You can run the Ghost Ogres and Snow Rabbits or the Effect Veilers. Your choice, guys. Whatever you guys see fit. Next, for the spells, three copies of Pre-Preparation of Rites. That's going to follow up with two copies of Dark Dragon Ritual. The reason why you run this is, for obvious reasons, you want to be able to get into your Dark Dragon Ritual because it is a free Red Eyes Darkness Metal to your side of the field. And if you use a Red Eyes monster for Tribute Summon, that Darkness Metal can bring back that Red Eyes monster for practically free. No real cost required, my apologies. Next is two copies of Red Eyes Insight. I would not run three of this card because there's not a lot of Red Eyes cards that are great to search into. Now, we don't run a Fusion variant. Red Eyes Fusion would be awesome if it allowed you to at least normal summon afterward. I don't know. It's just so frustrating. So, Red Eyes Insight, we don't play too many copies of targets for Red Eyes Insight, but it's great because it sends Red Eyes cards from our deck to the graveyard. One copy of Reinforcement of the Army to add the Gear Free. Soul Charge, because this card is nutty inside of this deck. Two copies of Dragon Shrine. This allows you to send two dragon monsters from your deck to your graveyard. I know it's not just a Foolish Burial. You can send two with this deck to fuel up for your Dragon Revival Rhapsody play. Now, this card is awesome in here. Basically, if you control a Spellcaster monster, cough, cough, make Wee Witch, cough, cough, you know, make Cosmo Brain, then you can summon two monsters to your side of the field. That's actually where Cosmo Brain comes in so much in handy because it sets up plays like that. Where's that Cosmo Brain? Let me just put emphasis on how important Cosmo Brain is, because it sets up plays like that, and I can't find Cosmo Brain. Oh, here it is. It sets up plays like that because it's a Spellcaster monster. It allows Dragon's Revival Rhapsody to pop off, and even more importantly, you can just make Wee Witch Magician and allow this card to pop off. Now, you can't inflict damage to your opponent, and it is only once per turn, but it's still really, really, really fun to play. Next is two copies of Cards of Redstone. This card allows you to dig deeper into your deck by sending Red Eyes cards from your hand to the graveyard. It's not necessarily a pot of greed, but it does fuel the strategy. And then lastly for the traps is three copies of Red Eyes Fang with Chain. This card is nutty good because you equip it to a Red Eyes and you can snatch your opponent's monsters on their turn. So you equip it to the Gearfried. You can use the Gearfried effect to summon a monster, or you can use this effect to snatch your opponent's monster and then the Gearfried's effect to summon a monster. So that's all really good. For the extra deck for Red Eyes, it's basically going to be the exact same thing. Of course, your Boroboy, your Griffin, your Saryuja, Unicorn, Proxy Dragon, Nightmare Griffin, or Nightmare Cerberus, Nightmare Goblin. This card actually has more utility in this deck. Clefort Genius, Nightmare Phoenix, Link Spiders, and Galaxy Tomahawk. The only difference that we play is we take out the Summon Sorceress and, of course, the two Dark Magician cards. And in return, you run Reed Witch's Apprentice. This is a Dark Spellcaster. So you use two Dark Monsters to make this, and instantly your Dragon Revival Rhapsody is immediately playable. And then, of course, two copies of Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon. Now, we don't use the Fusion Monsters, mainly because they're so hard to fusion into. I thought about running Dragon's Mirror, but it just didn't fulfill the deck how I wanted it to. Nonetheless, these decks are still really fun to play, really awesome, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm going to show you guys a quick combo, then we're going to get out of here with Cosmo Brain. Okay, so we're going to go over the Dark Magician combo first, and it can be extended depending on what you have in your hand. This combo is going to require Magician's Ride, Cosmo Brain, and Dark Magician in your hand, as well as other cards that will, you know, make your combo a little better. So what you are going to do is normal summon your Magician's Rod using Magician's Rod effect to add Dark Magical Circle. Now, if you already have Dark Magical Circle, Eternal Soul or Magician's Navigation are all excellent choices depending on what you have. Activate the Dark Magical Circle and hope that you hit Eternal Soul or Magician's Navigation, because that would be even more awesome. Then add it to your hand. Next, you're going to use the effect of Cosmo Brain to send the Dark Magician from your hand to the graveyard to summon the Brain, and then use Brain's other effect to send the Magician's Ride to summon your second copy of Dark Magician to your side of the field. Use both of these monsters for a link summon into number 42 Galaxy Tomahawk. And then the combo is going to go a little bit different, just a wee bit different. We're going to detach two materials to special summon five tokens to our side of the field. I know, right? They're all Dark Magician Girl. And then one's like Magical Hats Karibo. And then we're going to use the Galaxy Tomahawk and these two for a link summon. And that's actually going to make your, of course, your Clefort Genius. Next, I'm going to use this token to make the Link Spider. And then I'm going to use the Link Spider and a token not to make Nightmare Goblin, though you can make Nightmare Goblin if you have like a Spellbook Magician to your side of the field, or, you know, if you need, you do make the Nightmare Goblin. My apologies. I was actually going to make Nightmare Cerberus and then put it in the main monster zone. That makes no more sense. You're going to make the Nightmare Goblin to your side of the field, discard a card, and if you have the Spellbook Engine, then go ahead and use your normal summon for the Spellbook Engine, or if you drew another's Magician's Rod, I don't think it's once per turn. You can only use each of... Yeah, it's once per turn, unfortunately. Use your normal summon your Spellbook and then gain the effect of your Spellbook monster again. Next, you're going to use your Clefort Genius and your two tokens. I'm sorry, that's what I was doing wrong. You're going to use your two tokens to make your Proxy Dragon. And then you're going to use your Clefort Genius and your Nightmare Goblin as link material to make your Nightmare Griffin. Now, the reason why I did that, made the Proxy Dragon before the Nightmare Griffin, is because now the Nightmare Griffin isn't pointing into any extra monster zone, meaning that it is the only monster linked. And when you summon Dark Magician, it doesn't matter where you summon your Dark Magician monster, mainly because it doesn't have an effect anyway. So it's really good to get your Nightmare Goblin inside of a zone, or you can summon it right here, inside of a zone where a monster doesn't point to. And even more importantly, you can actually activate Griffin's effect, discarding a card. I don't have any spells or traps in my graveyard right now, but discarding a card to set a spell or trap card to your side of the field to draw a card. Let's show you the Red Eyes combo, though. Now, the combos with Red Eyes has a higher ceiling. It has, like, way higher of a ceiling, and I think it shows because Joey does have more potential than Yugi, and only in the essence that Yugi is pretty much, you know, hit his prime. He's at his top of his game. And Joey has not seen that potential realized. So the 3-card, or actually it's a 4-card combo that you need. You are going to need Black Flare Dragon. You're also going to need Cosmo Brain and Red Eyes B-Dragon, as well as Dragon Revival Rhapsody. Now, you are going to need to change up your contents of your extra deck a bit, playing another Clefairy Genius and a Summoned Sorceress, but I'm going to show you, you're going to get insane with your combos. What you're going to do is normal summon your Black Metal Dragon, and then special summon your Cosmo Brain by sending Red Eyes B-Dragon. Use the effect of Cosmo Brain to send Black Metal Dragon to the graveyard to special summon Red Eyes, and then trigger Black Metal Dragon's effect to add Red Eyes Insight. Use Cosmo Brain for a X-Seed summon for number 42, Galaxy Tomahawk, and then Tomahawk to special summon 5 tokens to your side of the field. Here's 1, here's 2, here's 3. Where's the 4 and 5? I can't find my 4 and 5, guys. I don't even know what I did with all my tokens. Whatever. This will be 4 and 5. We're going to use them to get rid of immediately. Use these two. Well, actually, it doesn't matter. Use these two tokens to make your first Clefairy Genius. And then your second two tokens to make a second Clefairy Genius. Where's my first Clefairy Genius? All right. And then these two tokens, it doesn't matter. I'm going to use these two. You just got to clear that area to make your second Clefairy Genius. Now use use both Clefairy Genius. That'll be a proxy for Clefairy Genius. Use both of these Clefairy Geniuses to make your Summoned Sorceress. And now you control a Spellcaster monster, so you can activate Dragon's Revival Rhapsody. Use Rhapsody to special summon Black Metal Dragon towards Summoned Sorceress point 2 and a Red Eyes Black Dragon right under it. And now you can use Summoned Sorceress effect targeting the Black Metal Dragon to special summon another Red Eyes monster to your side of the field. And we're going to special summon Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon to our side of the field. Or you can actually summon another Black Metal Dragon. My apologies. That actually would be better. Where's that second Black Metal Dragon, guys? Special summon a second Black Metal Dragon. Use both of these monsters for link material. Did I already use my insight? No, I haven't. I mean, you should have used the insight a long time ago, but use the insight. That'll add your Red Eyes Fang with Chain. Now use both of your Black Metal Dragons to make Nightmare Goblin. And then activate your effects. So we're going to discard... Where's my Nightmare Goblin? We're going to discard the Fanguine Chain, but we're going to gain 2 more cards from our decks to our hand, which will be Black Metal Dragon and another Fanguine Chain. Now, so obviously I felt like you could have... Now that I'm like looking at it, I did mess up a little bit on this combo. You could have actually just added another Red Eyes card to pitch into your graveyard. Now you have an additional normal summon, a Red Eyes monster, a Nightmare Goblin, and Summoned Sorceress. And there is endless amount of possibilities. You can actually use this to make the Saryuja, or to make the token, the Link Spider, and then follow up with these 4 to make Saryuja, draw an additional 4 cards. You can additional normal summon with the monster, and then use it to special summon that. You could have used the additional normal summon for the Nightmare Goblin, or you could have kept the card in your hand, or you could have just added a Gearfreak, and you could have a Red Eyes Fanguine Chain, Gearfreak the Iron Knight, and another monster. Or you could have discarded another card and continued on with this combo. Like I said, this deck has so much potential. It is ridiculous. Use those 2 monsters to X-Seed summon into a Red Eyes Flare Metal Dragon, then Black Metal Dragon to special summon itself or another Metal Dragon to your side of the field. You can use these 2 monsters to link off again into a Proxy Dragon, effectively protecting it and gaining another search, or you can use it to summon a Red Eyes Black Dragon to your side of the field, 2700 monster with a Red Eyes Fang with Chain. Thank you guys so much for watching another segment of the Cali Effect. I apologize if I seemed a little bit too rushed, but it is 2 deck profiles I had to go over once. Please like, comment, subscribe. But most of all, enjoy. I hope you guys have a great day, like I am. Believe in the heart of the cards.